part of editing in long form narration or industrial narrations is getting good at editing on the fly, meaning recording. And while you're recording, if you make a mistake, stop, fix it, and pick up where you're at in real time. If you're doing a 30-minute narration for something and you make all those mistakes until you do all 30 minutes of read, you're going to end up with 45 to 60 minutes of all this raw track. Then you're going to have to come through and spend exactly the same amount of time, another 60 minutes, going through and listening, slowly fixing and editing your mistakes. Then you're going to have to come through a third time to final proof it to make sure that it's edited perfectly from start to finish. If you're doing a 10-hour audiobook, that's 30 hours, okay? And then some. So what I tell people to learn is the art of real-time editing on the fly. When you're reading a narration, if you make a mistake, right there, stop, pick up, fix it, back up, roll through what you did, and make sure it sounds good and continue on. By the time you're done, you will only have on the track the actual rough, cleaned up, edited track. Then you only have one more pass instead of two to go through and proof it. If you edit and fix, edit, fix, edit, fix as you go, then only got one time to listen to it to make sure it sounds good. Each of those 20-minute, 15-minute, 10-minute blocks you recorded only require a single extra listen to. If you don't edit on the fly, you're going to have three or four times as much time in a project. Narrators who are in the business know edit in real time on the fly cuts your work by at least even up to 50% in some cases. Okay. Very important part. It's like somebody who is cooking a meal in the kitchen, right? One of the very first things that I was taught back in my young days when I used to work in restaurant kitchens as a kid was clean up as you cook. You know, if you're thinking Thanksgiving or you're cooking Easter or you're doing a party or whatever, if you're done with a pan, you put it over there and you clean it real fast. If you're done with the herbs, put them back in the cabinet.
Yep.
Have a towel over your shoulder. Every chef you see will always have a towel over their shoulder so they can constantly clean as they go.
Yeah.
When you're done, then all you have is the food that's cooking and everything else is cleaned and put away. You don't have to then clean up a pile in the sink of dishes after dinner. The stove's a mess. There's stuff everywhere. The kitchen's a wreck. That's an efficient cook, somebody who knows how to clean on the fly. It's the same concept in the voiceover stuff. When you're narrating, clean up as you go, clean up as you go, clean up as you go. Then that 30 minutes of final track, you only have to save it as an edit and then come back and listen through to it as a final version. I can't begin to tell you how many people have said it to me. I can't believe how many hours a week I save of time by learning to edit on the fly. These are little things that a lot of other coaches really don't teach their students. They don't teach them these reality things of when you're in there, clean up as you're cooking. Don't wait until you're done with the meal. Clean as you go. When the meal's cooking and on the stove and in the oven, the kitchen's clean. And all then you can sit down with a glass of wine and watch the football game with everyone else. You know, if you don't clean as you go when you're a narrator, you're going to end up with all this crap. You're going to end up with all these F-bombs, all these mess-ups, all these, and you're going to try to be making madness out of it as you go.